Did someone screw up your perfectly correct QuickBooks Online records? Did they change something after you did bank reconciliation? Well, don't worry, because as we do this third consecutive bank reconciliation together, we will learn how to fix things using the Reconciliation Discrepancy Report. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The Reconciliation Discrepancy Report shows every change to any transaction that was already cleared in a prior reconciliation. It shows every detail of every change, like who changed it, when it was changed, and most importantly, how it was changed. It gives you the ability to fix most changes right from the report. But you may well ask, why do we need to use it in the first place? Well, let's imagine that we've always been doing bank reconciliation so that our bank statement records always match our QuickBooks Online records. This means month after month, both we and the bank are recording the same transactions, and at the end of each month, we stop and reconcile and make sure we agree. We've done this for several consecutive months, and we never move on to the next month until we stop and reconcile to make sure that we agree with the bank after each month when we get the bank statement. And our records are always in agreement. That's how we know our records are correct. But if somebody comes along and changes something, now we have a difference between our records and the bank's. And the cleared balance will change because you removed something or changed something before the date of the last reconciliation. Now our records are out of sync with the bank. And if that's the case, you will never be able to get the current month to match, no matter what you do, because you're already starting with different numbers. That's why you have to use the reconciliation report, because you cannot begin reconciling with the wrong beginning balance. You must fix what was changed in the past after the last reconciliation. You must use the reconciliation discrepancy report to see what was changed, how it was changed, and it will even help you change it back. Let's take a look as we attempt our third consecutive bank reconciliation. So let's imagine that we are innocently attempting to do the third month's reconciliation by clicking on the cogwheel and click reconcile. Now, as soon as we get to this window, you have a warning. Your account isn't ready to reconcile yet. And what's the reason? Your beginning balance is off by a certain amount. Right away, that's an indication that somebody changed something that was reconciled before the last reconciliation date, and they changed that, whatever those things are, after the reconciliation date. Now, let's go ahead and click We Can Help You Fix It and see what's there. Now, what you're looking at are all the changes that were made to items that were recorded before the reconciliation date and cleared the bank that somebody came along and changed after you did the reconciliation. Let's look at how this is organized. First of all, it tells you the transaction itself. For example, this check for $500. I don't know why it's not telling you the date, but that check is deleted. I happen to know what that check is, and I don't know why it's not showing you any information about the check. I guess we could click View. You can view it, and you can see that it was, you know, all the details about the check. It was check number 4. So check number 4 for $500 was deleted, and that was one change. So let's go back to reconcile and look at the report again. What else was changed? Well, this was uncleared in the register window. In other words, we learned in a previous video that the register window is the only window that can clear and unclear a transaction other than the reconciliation window itself. So you can see that this fourth payment, this sale receipt number four, that was done for Betty on January 18th, in the amount of $4,800, somebody went to the register and uncleared it and unreconciled it, and it removed it from the cleared balance. And the third change is a check, check number nine. Check number nine was already reconciled at $150 and it matched the bank. Someone came along after we did the last bank reconciliation and changed it to $510. So you can see these are all the changes that happened to anything that was recorded before the last reconciliation date, and someone must have come along and screwed up your numbers. Well, what do we do? Well, changed an amount is the easiest one to fix, and you can fix that right here from the report. If you click view, and well, you see the differences in the view, but you can click right on the transaction itself if it's not deleted. And if it's not deleted, you can just come along and you can just change it to the original amount and then click save and close and then click yes. You're getting a warning because QuickBooks doesn't know that we're fixing it. Now when you go back to reconcile, you see, we click here, and you can see that amount has now been fixed. Okay, what else do we need to fix? Well, this $4,800 for sale receipt number four, that was uncleared and unreconciled in the register window. We have to go back and fix it. Now, in order to fix that, in the register window, you can clear and unclear a transaction. But if you fix it, you have to keep clicking on it till you get the letter R. That means QuickBooks put it back as part of the cleared balance, and it is re-reconciled. Let's see if we can find that in the register. Well, by viewing it like this, we will not be able to fix it. We have to go to the register, which means we click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and we go to the cash and bank account, the one we're working on, and we click View Register, and now we try to find that sale receipt that happened back in February. Okay, which one was it now? Okay, that was sale receipt number four for Betty. Sale receipt number four. So let's take a look, okay? Sale receipt four. Here it is. This $4,800, some cosmic fool came along and clicked this and removed it from the cleared balance by removing the R. Let's go ahead and click on it, and let's, you know, to edit it, we'll click edit, and we'll click, we're not editing the actual transaction, we're just clearing it. So just click here. Now, don't click edit. We're not changing the money amount. Click in this box. If you click once, it's a C, which means it was downloaded from the bank. Click again, and it's reconciled. And after you save and click yes, you're getting a warning that you're changing the cleared balance. But in this case, we're fixing it. So we click yes. And now when we go back to the reconciliation report, you can see, boom, that the only one that remains is the one for $500 that was deleted. Now, deleting is a different story. A deleted transaction must be re-entered, and then after you re-enter it, you must clear it in the register window. Well, I happen to know enough about that check to be able to re-enter it. I happen to know that was made on February 5th, check number four, for $500 to establish the petty cash fund. Now, you can find out more about what's in your reconciliation or what was changed by clicking view. Now, of course, if it's a deleted transaction, you can't click up here like we did for the other two and go back to the original transaction. But we can click Show All and get a little more information about it. You can see a little bit more about it. It says the date, and it says the amount, and it says the number. And the reason why there's no name is because when we established the petty cash fund a few months ago, we left the name blank because we were not really writing it to a person. But all we have to do is re-enter it exactly as it's written here, and then don't forget to clear it again so that it will be part of the cleared balance. We click New, Check. The date of the check was February 5th of 2017. And there was no payee, but the money went to the petty cash account, which should be somewhere here. Yep, cash on hand, petty cash, and the amount was $500. So we re-enter what was improperly deleted. Make sure it says check number 4, because that was the check number before it was deleted. Now, we're not finished fixing it. If you try to reconcile right now, you will still see the $500 difference. That's because you re-entered it, but you did not again go and clear it to make it part of the cleared balance. You have to take this extra step. Go to the chart of accounts so that you can open up the register. Find the check that you entered, and the register is in date order. So when we come down here, here it is. Now click on it so we edit it. And how are we going to clear it? Well, what you have to do is come across to this here, to this box here where the R should normally be. Clicking once only puts a C, and that tells QuickBooks it was downloaded from the bank. But clicking it twice puts an R, which means it was already part of a bank reconciliation. So click Save and click Yes, because we're fixing it, and congratulations. Now when we click Reconcile, you can see that there is no discrepancy, and we are ready to do our third consecutive month without a problem. And now that we fixed the beginning balance, let's do March's reconciliation normally. You can pause the video here and try it yourself. If it doesn't work, then you can undo what you've done and follow along with me. Let's take a look. We're going to click Reconcile, and here we are, and now we're just going to put in the ending balance, which I can copy right from the statement because I'm using Excel, you see. And of course, you should get rid of the dollar sign. And of course, the ending date, which should be March, I guess it's March 31st of, remember, 2017. So now we have our beginning information, and we click Start Reconciling. Now, of course, there's a difference, and we go one by one just like we learned. Let's scooch over here a little. Okay, so transaction check number 10 for $1,700. Let's check where it is. Is it here? Yes, it is. We mark it off in QuickBooks, and we change the color here in the reconciliation. What about check number 11 for $450? Is that the same? Yes, it is. We mark it off, and then we come back. Okay, the $8,000 deposit, do we have an $8,000 deposit? Yes, we do. We mark it off, and we come back, change it to blue. I'm going to go a little faster. Rex Repair Shop, a check for $1,000. The Excel screwed up the number, but we do have a check to Rex Repair. Oh, he didn't screw up the number. It's a long, weird number because that was an expense and a transfer. paid online rather than paid by check. But it's good. So we make it blue. Now, what about this 2660? Is that there? 2660, mount matches, everything matches. Click blue. Good. What about 2400? Okay, the 2400 is there. Good. What about, well, we'll make it blue if it's in QuickBooks Online. What about this 595? Let's check it out. 595 is there, so we come back to Excel and make it blue. What about check number 13 to Staples for 725? Check number 13 to Staples for 725. I think I can get rid of this PowerPoint here. Okay, now let's make it blue if it was in QuickBooks Online. Now, check number 700 to UPS, a check for 700 to UPS was also there. Okay, it's a big weird number, but it's there. So we come back and we make it blue. Let's scroll down a bit. What about this $230 deposit? Is that there? Okay, let's go. Yeah, sure it is. So if it's there, then we come back and we mark it in blue. Normally it would have a description that explains it a little better when you download it from the bank. But I'm using Excel. So what about this check number 15 to 1200 to Betty? Let's check if that's there. 1200 to Betty, check number. Okay, they have the check number there. Okay, let's make it blue. Right? Now, what about this 2400? This 2400, is that there? Yes, it is. We mark it off and we come back and we make it blue. What about this negative 1400? Is that there? Yes, it is. We mark it off and we come back in blue. What about this $700 deposit? Yes, it is. We mark it off. So if it's in QuickBooks Online, we come back, we make it blue. We're almost finished. What about this 900? Okay, 900 deposit is there. And again, a real statement would have a little more information in the description. What about the 3980? 3980 is there. So we come back and we mark it in blue. What about the 3924? Is that there? 3924, yes, it's there. We come back and we mark it in blue. Now, look carefully. There's still a difference, but look what happens. At the moment we mark off the second to last one, 1740 is here. So that means there's only one unchecked transaction in QuickBooks Online that's equal to the remaining difference. So this 1740 we agreed was there, we'll make it blue. That means this is all that's left on the bank statement. And again, I strongly stress, only at the moment you mark off the last item on the bank statement, that's the moment that it clears in QuickBooks Online and the difference goes to zero. So we cleared it in QuickBooks Online, which means we mark off the last one on the statement. Now when we're done, everything is marked off the March statement. They may or may not be completely marked off in QuickBooks Online, but at the moment you acknowledge that everything's marked off the March statement, that's the moment the difference became to zero. We click Finish Now, and of course we have added another report to our series of reports for bank reconciliation. And this report says the same things that we discussed about this report in previous videos. Congratulations, you have finished 3 consecutive months.